pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States to the republic for one nation, indivisible.
Oh, got two for.
Trying to pull up the agenda. Hello. Okay, let's go ahead and begin. Roll call. Amy?
Here.
Roman?
Here.
And myself. We are all here. I did have a question for you, Manny. Did we get another position filled on here?
Another position? No, we have not. Okay. I will have Teresa check with our deputy city clerk and find out what the status is on that. I believe we are vacant one commissioner position, maybe actually two.
Okay, I thought I heard somebody congratulate Ms. Vasquez that they probably said the wrong commission at the tree planting. So I was just wondering.
Oh, Ms. Margaret.
Gonzalo's.
Yeah, she was our commissioner for years.
Maybe they were just referring to that. Okay.
As far as I know, and I did miss one council meeting, but I tuned in.
Okay.
Haven't had any additional.
Okay. Just wondering. All righty. Perfect. Okay. We'll move on to approval of certificate of posting for May 2nd. If I can get a motion.
I motion.
I second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Okay. Let's go to the approval of minutes for the April 4th meeting. A motion?
I motion.
I second.
All in favor?
Aye. Aye.
Okay, next is public communication, but I see nobody here, no interest, so we'll go ahead and close that and go right into the reports of officers, commissioners, or committees. And we'll begin with the Mental Health Awareness Walk, Fair, and Car Show on May 7th.
Thank you, Madam Chair. I'll turn it over to April Rojo, Program Coordinator. She is the staff liaison in charge of this event coming up this Saturday.
Yes, I sent an email a little while ago in regards to the event. We are hosting our opening ceremonies here at City Hall in the courtyard at 10:30 a.m. And for everyone interested in participating in the free walk, it starts at 11 a.m. right after our opening ceremonies. And this opening ceremonies just consist of a little introduction and some kudos to the partnering groups that are participating, which are True Pride Car Club, the Baldwin Park Unified School District, Project Hope, and Looms for Lupus. I think I'm forgetting someone. Oh, and Ode to Country Foundation, which they bring out a lot of veteran participants, military veterans. From there, the walk is going to go up north on Main, left on Clark, and another left on Baldwin Park Boulevard, to end in through the back driveway of Morgan Street at Morgan Park. And festivities there are from 12 to 4 p.m. We are still open to receiving vendors because we noticed a lot of them contacted us today that they still wanted to participate. So we've been signing up vendors. The funds raised through those vendors are going to be distributed from the car show and the vendors distributed to the both high schools. For their band trailer. And basically at Morgan Park, we're going to have live entertainment at the stage. We're going to start off kicking it off with Son de Calavera since it's Cinco de Mayo weekend. They're a trio that kind of play a big variety. And then we have Flacorico dancers. And we have a check presentation at both high schools. They're both going to be on site participating. And then after that, we have Rocky Padilla, who is performing from 1:15 to 2 o'clock, and Rocky Padilla is well known in the lowrider community. And we're going to end our festivity entertainment from 2 to 4 with the concert from Little Willie G, the original voice of the Midnighters. And then aside from that, we have a lot going on. Project Hope is doing free haircuts, free groceries, a lot of informational vendors that are passing out really helpful information for mental health. All the participants in the walk will receive a medal, a participant medal. And I'm trying to think what else. Oh, the car show. The car show, we're expected to bring a little over 200 cars. So it should be a nice turnout. They have a big bicycle following and motorcycles. So we're going to have a good variety of things to see out there this week. So we're looking forward to Saturday.
Where are the cars going to be at?
The cars? We're going to park them in a U surrounding the athletic field. So all the way from our restrooms, the park restrooms, all the way down that street. And they're just going to create a large U. And then they're going to be parked like right in back of each other. So it'll create more of a walkable feel in that area to see cars on both sides.
And the vehicles will be parked on the street?
Yes, on the street. And vendors will be in the grass area on the lawn.
Having a beer garden?
Yes, and we have a beer garden as well. I forgot about that. VMR sponsors a beer garden there in the amphitheater area, grass area, and they sell refreshments and ceviche, margaritas, and beer. Yes.
Yes.
But I don't know if you wanted to say anything about the donation.
I think we are going to be donating the funds generated. So we're not quite sure. It's going to be probably a few thousand for each high school. So because the funds will be towards the high schools to purchase a trailer for the bands. Apparently the bands need a trailer for the evening. Apparently they're renting one. Mm-hmm. Air would like to contribute. That's pretty much it. Any questions, comments?
I'm going.
My mom's super excited.
What is the best time to be there so the council could acknowledge them on the break?
What time would that break? The break is 2:45 to 1:15. No, 2:45, 3:15. Yes, 45 to 3:15 stage area, so that way we can acknowledge all our commissioners.
One more time, April. What time are we beginning the festivities here?
10:30 a.m.
Sounds so exciting. Okay, thank you so much for that, April. We'll go ahead and move on to the next.
Hey, Madam Chair, I'll pass the baton to Helen Hernandez, and she would talk about Sound the Alarm. At this time, I'd also like to acknowledge Helen. She was recently promoted from program supervisor to community services supervisor. So congratulations.
All right. Very good. What can you tell us what she does different from what she was doing to what she does now?
Hey. If you ask Helen that, she's going to say, well, I'm fairly compensated now, but she is doing more complex items than what she was doing before. I'm not sure if everyone realizes Helen is in charge of the city's social media campaign, as well as other complex projects, grants, and things of that nature. So she is doing very well, and she's being rewarded for all of her hard work and dedication to the city. She's been with us for how many years, Helen? 27 years, and of those 27 years, full-time, how many? 22 years. So. I still remember her walking her into her interview when she was going to be hired as a rec leader.
I remember working with her as a rec leader.
A while ago.
The first came, yeah.
Oh, and I was with Frank Connor and you
said. Yes, at the first. Yes.
Yes.
So, been around a while. I am doing some more complex stuff. I'm starting to work on bigger things like RFPs. So I'm doing helping to organize the city's committee for a new website. So we are working on a new website. It's coming. It's a little bit slow, but it's we're all learning because we want to make sure we get it right. And then we're also going to be working on the Barnes Park expansion project. That's pretty cool to work on a capital improvement project. And storm drain water capture is actually really interesting. I never knew.
Nice.
So it's pretty cool. So thank you, Manny, for that. But I did bring flyers in case you aren't aware of it. We are taking volunteers, and we're still taking appointments. So if anyone you know needs a smoke detector or wants to come on and volunteer for this event, we'd love to have them to volunteer or to come out and register to get it installed. It's free to be installed in the home. So people can just go to the website, sign themselves up, and it'll make an appointment for them to get it installed. The morning of, the Red Cross is coming to Morgan Park. They're going to train the volunteers to go out in teams of 3 to 4 individuals. That team would go to a house or whatever. They'll be trained with a step ladder. One will be a recorder. One will be an installer. And then one will share some safety tips about smoke detection and fire safety with the families that they're installing them. It's all completely free. There's no like documentation of like a house deed or anything, but they do need to be able to give permission to have it installed. All the volunteers will arrive at 8 o'clock. We'll have a little session before they go out, so they won't actually install till about 9:30-ish. So we're not waking anyone up early on a Saturday morning. They'll have to go through a small training before they go out. And then once they're done, they're going to come back. And the goal is to install 100 smoke detectors in Baldwin Park. And we have about 30 appointments right now, so we're hoping that we can spread the word out. We've been trying to get it out there with the school district, our partners at the credit union, Kaiser. So we still need more volunteers, and we still need more houses to install in. And that's on Saturday, May 14th.
On Saturday, May 14th, connected at Morgan Park, our meeting there where they sound the alarm, LA County Department of Mental Health having another mental health awareness day. They're having ours on the 7th. It so happens that they're having one the following. Together, so in 2023, we'll have one event, hopefully. Should know anyone that is looking for a smoke detector service. The smoke detectors are going to be, battery life is a decade.
Wow. Nice. Very good. Okay.
I'll turn it back over to April Rojo. She is going to discuss a little bit about the Baldwin Park now and where we are at, and it should be hitting the residents' homes pretty soon.
Yes. We're going to have the Baldwin Park Nows delivered tomorrow. Our link via web was available last week. And this issue of the Now is covering May, June, and July, so it had a lot of great information. The cover page of our Baldwin Park Now was in regards to the Socalo Park that's going to be revamped in our downtown area. Just providing, council thought it was a good idea to provide residents with more information in regards to the street closures and location, a few pictures, and we also have the state of the city address information on there, so they can visit the link on our website for the video for the state of the city address, which is live.
It'll be live May 18th.
Okay. And we highlighted some city accomplishments in there. And the back page of this Now had a lot of upcoming summer events. Little highlight to our summer concerts and downtown street market events, and we have another blood drive in June. So there's a lot going on, our summer day camp programs, and then this issue was the first issue kicking off our ARP program for small businesses. Small businesses here in Baldwin Park of 10 employees or less qualify for a small business card size ad in the Baldwin Park Now. And it's a one-time ad. So this one kicked off with six businesses due to some space issues that we had. But we're still going to be connecting. We have staff going out to all the small businesses. We're working off a list that was given to us from with community development. And we are getting the word out. So if you know any small businesses that would qualify and want to get their information out, it's free ad. They just have to fill out a general form that we keep on file. And we do the design and layout of their ad if they need assistance in that area. So that'll be ongoing until we finish those funds, basically. But the Baldwin Park Now, this one had a lot of information, huh, man?
This is a great Baldwin Park Now. I, in my humble opinion, I think this might be the most colorful, most best now that we've ever put together. Goes to April on her team. Looks really already available via the website, on social media, and so on. Very excited for the residents.
It should be mailed to them on Wednesday because they're delivering it to the post office tomorrow.
Okay. Very good. Looking forward to seeing that. What time did you say the state of the city was?
Well, the state.
It's not a time. It's a video that's going to just go live.
Well, it's just a video.
Okay. Yeah. State of the city is virtual for the final year this year. When we started the planning process months ago, we were still in COVID. We wanted to make sure we were able to deliver on the state of the city, so we decided to go virtual as we did the previous year. And so that's another project that's coming out to look really neat. So looking forward to everyone seeing that, as Helen mentioned, May 18th, if not sooner.
Perfect.
Madam Chair, if you don't have any additional questions, I'll pass it back over to Helen because she's going to talk about movies on the green.
Hey, movies on the green. They'll be back at Barnes Park this year. We're going to be starting on Friday, June 3rd. So we'll have a month of movies before the concerts begin. Every Friday will be a fairly new movie. We're starting with Space Jam, the new version with LeBron James. And then we'll have Luca, which has been pretty popular. The Addams Family 2, and then we'll finish off with Encanto, which has been super popular. So we have some great movies out there. Barnes Park has been just a happening spot. So many families are just happy to be out and about again, and with the really nice weather, it's definitely very, very, very busy after 6 p.m., so we don't have any worries about there being a crowd out there, but just let everyone know to bring a blanket or some sweaters, because after a little while, it does get windy out there by the freeway, so it does cool off pretty good out there. It should be a nice summer out there again. We'll have our blow-up screen and staff doing games to keep them busy before the movie starts. And then we'll run through June and then kick off the concerts the following Thursday. Summer is already upon us.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Thank you, Helen. So we'll go ahead and go into Commissioner, if any of you have any questions or comments or... want to bring up anything? Me?
No, I can't think of anything at the moment, but I'm looking forward to seeing the summer and what concerts are coming in. Are these the finalized movies? Like, there's going to be four movies?
Those are all paid for. And then I forgot to mention, we did have our Keep Baldwin Park Beautiful this past Saturday. Mm-hmm. We had a really good turnout. We had over 75 volunteers.
Nice.
They did a great job. So when you're leaving, if you want to drive down Bogart, you can... definitely noticed the impact they made. We cleaned up the whole alleyway going just behind Pacific, behind those businesses, liquor store and stuff. And then also this whole section from about the walkover bridge to the corner of Pacific and Bogart. Definitely new landscaping, new trees were planted.
Nice.
Tons of mulch and colorful mulch out there. Flowers, drought-tolerant plants. It's a night and day difference. And then
nice.
The plan is to continue the same thing on with the removal of the bushes and put much more colorful items all the way down the rest of the MetroLink station. Definitely a huge.
Nice.
I wanted to go to that, but I was out of town, and I was like, but I'll go next year.
We're going to have another one.
Okay.
I wanted to finish the other half of the MetroLink, and then there's just some other smaller things that everyone wants to pitch in and take a.
Awesome.
Comment?
I was out at the Arbor Day celebration. Unfortunately, I didn't make Easter. I was at my own Easter event. Congratulations on the staff. It was very nice touch. I knew all three families. I didn't realize I knew some of Betty Lowe's family members. But it was very nice, very classy, and staff did a really good job out there.
Yeah, I'd like to agree with Roman. I was able to come to that as well as the Easter. And great job. Staff did such an amazing job. All the vendors, it was just really, really exciting. It was fast. Staff had it all organized together. Yeah, and then kicking it off with the tree planting was just amazing. So I do have two questions. One, and this might not be where we go with it, where I go with it, but you can direct me to where. So with the minimum wage going up, and I know we start employees at that, but what about those that have been here a while and trying to get them up where they maybe should be or, you know, need to be to keep them happy and keep them here?
That's a very good question, Madam Chair. We have recently had some challenges in regards to our new minimum wage increase. I'm not sure if everyone realizes California or LA County minimum wage is $15 an hour mm-hmm. for anyone that has, I believe, over 25 plus employees. The city of Baldwin Park made a decision a few months ago to increase the minimum wage for all entry-level positions to $16.82, which is wonderful. But what we failed to do and what we're going to do is it was explained to me that we were going to address the second element as part of the new fiscal year. I'll give you an example. We could have an employee, John Doe, who was making $15 an hour, then all of a sudden he or she went up to $16.82. And Roman probably has a good understanding because he deals with all part-time staff. So now they went from $15 to $16.82, which is fantastic.
Right.
And then you have a little bit more of a senior staff member mm-hmm. making $15.80.
Right.
That went up to $16.82. But maybe in their specific case, maybe we bumped them up a little bit to $17.15 because that would be the next mm-hmm. step over. And we did that to many of them. But as a result, we had some staff members that were a little concerned because a day one employee, a newbie, as they would they would say, is making identical or very close to what they're making. That's something that I did share with our leadership team, and they are going to try to address it. If anyone has time, I noticed over the weekend that Mayor Pro Tem Danny Damian added under city council discussion a conversation about that. And I think that's probably some feedback that he may have received from some of the staff members in Recreation Community Services or maybe another department. I'm not quite sure. It is on our radar. It is very important for us to make the adjustments. And that's the intent of the city manager as well as the city council. At the time, they wanted to wait for the new fiscal year. I kind of wish they would have done it all at one time, but on the other side, it is a very complex matter, and that's probably mm-hmm. why we haven't been able to get our hands around it
right.
all these years. Once we probably got it right the last time when Roman was working with us. But the minimum wage goes up every year on a dollar.
Yeah.
So by the time, if you could visualize our salary chart, mm-hmm. everyone gets blacked out.
Right.
So then all of a sudden, everyone's making the same amount of money. So what the city council did, they went up from $15 to $16.82, which is very generous.
Yes.
But it doesn't address the long-term employees that have been with us mm-hmm. a decade or even longer. some cases. So we're hoping to rectify it. It's on the city council agenda.
Awesome.
I believe Mayor Pro Tem requested for discussion, direction to staff to incorporate it into the next fiscal year. And I hope that's what we're going to accomplish, because I've had a handful of staff members approach me, and the conversations are, you know, vary, but they're just concerned that they want to be fairly compensated, and I understand where they're going. Although they received a dollar raise, it complicates matters when the new hires are making identical.
Right.
Thank you for bringing that up, and I'm hoping to have better news in the next month or two. It should try to be resolved. I think I'm personally going to try to take a crack at it, because it is very complicated. Yeah, it's 2.5 that way, 2.5 this way. But I think what we're going to do, rather than having rec 1, 2, 3, 4, 5s, we may simplify it, because the gap is so much and there's compaction with full-time staff. So comments that I'm receiving from HR is that some of our part-time staff will surpass the hourly rate of full-time staff. I have to look at that a little bit closer. That's what they're sharing with us, because we have 5 steps. So I'm thinking maybe making a recreation leader 1, recreation leader, or maybe recreation leader, and then a senior rec leader. So then we would remove these steps. So we have to play with it. It is a never-ending juggling act, because then you need the resources to fund those positions,
which
is another complicated matter.
Mm-hmm. No, I appreciate the thorough explanation.
We talk about it all the time, and we are looking for solutions.
I will have some conversations before Wednesday, just to give input and, you know, share. I definitely think that, you know, we, in order to retain those valuable staff, you know, we need to make sure that we're keeping them happy and doing what we can for them.
Absolutely. So. Thank you for bringing that, that up.
And then my second one was, do we still have openings? Are you still with the job search open?
Okay. We still need to recruit at least another 12 people for special events.
Okay.
And specifically the special events, they have to be available every Thursday from June 15.
Okay.
And then we're asking them to leave July 2nd and August 6th available as well.
Okay. And then on those special events, how many hours are you looking at? 8 hours. Okay. Perfect.
Yeah. And for the first time, because we're lean on staff, we're paying overtime. It is not good practice that we have. I don't know in your city if you guys have your part time go overtime. We never, not that I'm old school or anything, we never did that, period. Avoided it like the plague.
Right.
But now we are rolling past overtime. We are rolling because we need the help.
Yep.
And, you know, our residents come first. And usually staff has no issues working beyond those
extra hours.
Because, you know, they're looking for additional funds also.
So I have a couple people interested. So what's the next time?
So you can go to baldwinpark.com.
Okay.
Unless they're already registered on government jobs, they can look for us on governmentjobs.com.
Okay.
But the easiest way is to go to our website under personnel. It's a drop-down screen that says employment opportunities applications. That is a hyperlink directly to our government jobs landing page. And then specifically, we still have plenty of positions, recreation leader 2, special events. The other ones might already be off yet, but I know my position specifically.
Okay.
But we do require Thursdays, and it says it on there, and then the 4th of July event and our 5K run, mandatory for special event people.
But the 4th of July event, is that on the 2nd?
It's on the 2nd.
It's on the 2nd, okay. Okay, perfect. No, that's good.
Traditionally, it's on the 4th.
Right, yeah, okay.
And Manny was talking about overtime. This week, we literally have staff working 7 days this week. It's the meal delivery, or yesterday with the prep, today with the delivery, and our mental health awareness is Saturday, and some of the staff that found or the stage, they're
It's challenging. I mean, councils did us a great favor by increase in minimum wage. Yeah, we're not able to fulfill all the positions. So we're going to keep on hiring. There aren't many people that we turned away and did not hire.
Wow.
I have a philosophy that everyone's trainable. Everyone deserves an opportunity. So we practice what we preach, and we hired a number of staff.
Awesome. That's great. That's all I had.
About 20 the first week, and then about 17 this last jumper.
Nice. Nice.
Enjoyed it.
Yeah, it was good.
Very good.
HR was happy to be there, too. Yeah. Everyone.
Awesome. That's good. Great. That's great to hear. He'll be calling you.
Yeah. Well, even today, the HR actually wasn't in the office, but since they filed the paperwork at the job fair, a young man came in this morning. He got his fingerprints done, and he got it all because they had given the and then took care of the process. But it was just kind of sleeping in his but we were able to schedule for the next part till the results come back. But I mean, nice. For them to walk away already, their letter, offer letter, they had their appointments and everything to go. I mean, that's the process.
That's awesome. Very good. Okay, that's it. Does anybody want a motion to adjourn?
A motion.
I second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Adjourn at 5:32.
We'll see you on Saturday, hopefully.
On Saturday, yes.
Okay,
you said it.
And Roman,
I'm gonna
congratulations
try for
on your new position.
Yes.
I'm going to take you to lunch over there,
too.
Not yet. I'm going back.